yesterday we worked on a member from St. Luke's. That's the parish that we're partnered with down here. This is a woman in her 70s. They were all evacuated, she and her five children and their, you know, her grandchildren and great-grandchildren to Atlanta. And she basically said it would be nice. My mom's coming back December 20th to make her road home application, go to the doctor. It would be nice if her kitchen could be in order, if her dishes could be washed, if the linoleum and carpet in the bedroom could be removed so the room would look clean.
There was so much emphasis on how good God is on her walls, and when she talked to us on the phone, how good God is and Jesus will take care of me. And I kept thinking, look around, Lee, how good has he been? But it was still there. On the phone, she was saying, God is so, I'm so lucky, God is so good to me. And I thought, if she can think that, anybody can think that.
This is actually one of the first projects that we're doing that seems to involve quite a bit of, quite a finished house. And, you know, it's really looking like a house again. She's got all brand new drywall inside. It looks as if it's wired also, but what we're doing is priming the new wallboard, top to bottom. And you can really see a lot of hope in the homeowner's eyes. She's just beaming. Every little drop of paint that goes on the wall and everything done, and the closer she gets to moving back in, you could just see how happy she's, you know, she's getting excited because she's, and she, the one thing I noticed she said to us, which really was nice, she said, I don't care what color y'all paint it, I just want to get my bed in here. So she's just really, really excited to be at this stage and back in her house with it, you know, resembles a house again.
They were just so sweet and so happy for us being there. And it was just, it was nice to do reconstruction rather than destruction, and to see someone that in a couple months would actually move back into their house.
It would be so easy, I think, for big time contractors or developers to just come in and plow down all the homes without giving homeowners an opportunity to make the decision for themselves or, you know, do the rogue house and get the funds and rebuild if they want to. And I think that is a way New Orleans could take. I think they could buy the land off people, completely come in and bulldoze and start anew that way. But I think us being down here gives people hope that there's other people in the country that still care about them and want to help them rebuild the way they want to, give them the opportunity to take step forwards on their own, you know, enable them really to make that next step, no matter what it is.
People that we have talked to, they seem to be just grateful that we're here, and they keep saying, you know, we're just so tired. We're just so tired, and we're so glad that you're here because we're just tired. And it's like they're besieged.
After all our work on the first 3 days, we went on Saturday to the convention center in New Orleans. And we got these fun yellow t-shirts, and we all went out and we worked the convention floor.
Some people came back and it was their first time in the city for 15 months. They traveled in several hours, some of them, to be there. A few had never been evacuated. They were part of the 10% who'd stayed here. But the majority were beginning to trickle back in. They were in trailers. A few were getting back into their homes. And then there was a link with five other cities that have had been major places of dispersion. And it was linked by satellite so that in real time, everybody was joining together to make their voice heard about their vision for transformation for the city.
I was surprised sometimes about how people I didn't know would just open up to us and share their frustration. We spent a lot of time this morning with three folks talking outside the meeting because they felt discouraged. And we were out there for about 30, 40 minutes just listening to them tell their stories.
First they had an address, and Ray Nagin came up and said, this is a good thing. and he went away for 3 hours and then came back at the end. And then they had a little address where they discussed what was going on in New Orleans right now, and what then they went through a few plans, like community planning, like where the major hospital should be rebuilt, where the major fire station should be rebuilt.
There was something that I can only call grace. People who've been deeply traumatized, some of them had lost family members, several of them had lost homes, some had had very, very little damage. And yet they were prepared to come there, talk about the past, face the future, and be very clear about what they wanted. I was taken aback but not surprised by the level of anger that after 15 months, some of them were still seeing no change, no action, and a lot of anger at different levels of people within the power to, why was this not happening?
If I wouldn't have seen just this little bit more, this where we're rebuilding a little bit, I would have still had that impression of destruction and, you know, all that, which was, you know, so prevalent in my mind. But now to see this little bit of progress toward the growth, it makes me feel real hopeful and real glad that I came.